Hello friends, my name is RealMail and welcome back to some more Gran Turismo 3 Aspect. Today we're continuing on with our Let's Play. This is episode 30 and in today's mode we're taking a look at some more arcade mode. This time we're going to be taking a look at the C block of events that we have to do. So they are going to be in a particular order, in fact, because we're doing hard difficulty because that's how you unlock everything. They are going to be the Swiss Alps in reverse, the Trial Mountain Circuit in reverse, Deep Forest Raceway, Special Stage Route 5, Seattle Circuit, and the Piston Test Course. So we are going to go to Swiss Alps in reverse first because it's the first thing there. And what car are we going to use for it? Oh! We've unlocked the Delta as well. That's one car I kind of missed off at the last episode. I didn't know we unlocked more than one car. Hey, let's use the Delta. Unless the Silvia was already there. It might have been. I don't even know. I can't jokes in text-based reading. Well, I mean, yeah, there was a Kappa face on it. Anyways, what are we against here? I think it's a Subaru of some description. Is it not? Can't even see because it's just all dust. Yes, it's a Subaru. In fact, it's the Subaru Impreza prototype car because, apparently I've got to race my Delta against that. Yeah, I don't know, maybe, I don't think we unlocked three cars. What did we unlock last time from the prize pool? The MX-5? Yeah, it could have been the Silvia actually I unlocked. I don't actually really remember, if I'm being honest, so. Yeah, I guess it's the Silvia that I unlocked last time. I don't know. I should probably really look up what the prize car lists are for the arcade mode, because it would probably be advisable, I guess, to know said things. Anyways, Swiss Alps in reverse, pretty... I mean, to be fair, luckily for this episode, this block of events seems to be relatively nice to me, in the sense that it's going to be just a bunch of relatively short circuits, and then we've got test course at the end, which I'm still trying to plan what the hell I'm going to do for test course. Probably cry in a corner, maybe just try and build a car for it. I don't know, might use my Esperanto or something, just dump all the aero off it and do it that way. Either way, we've got a Subaru right on our rhombus, which is not a particularly good sight to see, Yeah, apparently this rally race has been a lot closer than previous rally races. I'm guessing it's down to A, I have no idea where I'm going on this track in reverse, and B, the Delta probably isn't the best of the rally cars. Like, granted, sure, in real life it was an extremely successful rally car. I believe it's the most successful rally car of all time, in fact. But, in terms of this game, it is slightly down on power, and I'd imagine it's slightly up from thingy. I got the Silvia from Group A, so I'm assuming the TT and this Delta was Group B, right? I wonder what I'm gonna get from Group C. I'll tell you what. Don't spoil the actual cars I can get from Group C, but if you want to sort of throw me a bonus to what class they're going to appear in, then that would be kind of neato, I guess. Friendo? I don't know. Mitsubishi, Citroen, Michelin. Yes. All those adverts truly go hand in hand together. Oh god, there we go. Mind you, what was it I just read? Renault Citroen? Yeah, Renault Citroen is not a thing. If it was Peugeot and Citroen together, it kind of makes sense because PSA Group exists. Correct. Right. Roger that. Tent. Tent. Do not crash a Delta into a tent. It's not a Mustang. It has doesn't a Delta. Actually, Deltas aren't known for crashing into crowds, are they? They're more just known for rolling down hills and catching on fire. Dark joke city. Ah. As a Subaru tries to do some bad things to my rear end. None of which I really want to happen. Just like that flight path was all over the place. Please switch down a gear car when I tell you to. I know you're a Lancia, but still. You're the Delta, which means you're a good Lancia. Actually, I don't think the Delta's really had too much history of faults. A and S class cars from this group, apparently. Gotcha. Also, bollocks, I thought that was the last lap. I actually kind of was hoping that was the last lap, because I had a sneaking suspicion that might happen if this went on any longer. Good night, Subaru. Anyways, so A and S class cars, gotcha. It's going to be in this group, which means I'm not expecting anything huge. I guess S-Class is probably going to have something not interesting A-Class might have. Maybe it's the Viper? Like the standard road-going GTS, perhaps? Wouldn't surprise me. As far as the S-Class car goes, I don't know, probably one of the other sort of GT300 cars in this game, which I don't think there's many of, come to think of it. And I don't think it's the Gran Turismo Edition cars, because I believe they're all career mode based. Ooh! Wee! I like to rotate in midair too. Ah, that was much better through there. Yeah, at least we're much safer on this particular run through than we were on the last one, because we did not feel particularly safe in the last one, but this one, I feel nice and cozy. And across the line, there we go. That is the Subaru dispatched of. Again, I think that's the first rally race I've actually done here where I've been legitimately threatened. Then again, the Impreza prototype car is quite the machine. Anyways, moving on to the next race. Next race takes place at Trial Mountain in reverse. So, what sort of car do I want for Trial Mountain in reverse? Supra? Sod it, we'll have a yellow Supra. Yes. Sure, why not? I'm trying to go with cars A, I haven't used before, B, no one would expect me to use, C, I don't expect to use in the actual career mode itself, so yeah, that's a tall order, and they're sort of in that order as well. Cars I haven't used, cars I wouldn't be expected to use, cars I'm not going to use in the career mode. It sort of goes in that order. Mind you, I guess cars no one would expect to, yeah, because I'm not going to use an Audi TT. Well, mostly because I've already used it in the career mode, but that's not the point. Anyways, by the looks of it, in this pack of cars, I might be slightly outclassed in our little Supra here, because we have many threatening-looking cars, including two NSXs, as we go a bit sideways, which is not something I particularly want to happen. The Supra finds its arch-nemesis. The Nissan GT-R Skyline, GT-R R34, GT-R Skyline, Skyline. Its prey is locked, because apparently these two cars were really comparable back in the day, even though they really were not. Because one has exactly the same amount of power as the other one, and it's got two less wheels to drive, which automatically means it's inferior, and also it costs a lot less, and also it meets the US emission laws and the other one didn't, and one gets crushed in America and one gets, well, memeified. Well, they both get memeified, really, but that's not the point. Unfortunately, you cannot go flying off this curb in that game, to my knowledge. As I go slightly sideways. And, yeah, the other two Japanese Kaido Kings pass through, because Kaido Racer, guys, Kaido. Fujimi Kaido is a real track, and I went drifting on there in a real car. Guys? Do you care? No. No, we don't. Right. Hey, Yakamaya. Just kill the R-34 on the way past, just for good measure. Because why not? Right, there we go. Beautiful. Right, so what we got? Trial Mountain, Deep Forest, Special Stage Route 5, Test Course. There's one course I'm missing. Wait, is there? Yeah, there's one course I'm missing from that. Is there another reverse stage in here? I'm not actually sure. Got five other tracks. What, I'm missing one of the tracks. Oh, no, I said Test Course, didn't I? Test Course, Special Stage Route 5. Excuse me. And then two others. Two others shouldn't be too difficult, I would imagine. Yeah, again, it's all just sort of short track. Oh, Seattle Circuit. That's the other one. Oh, fuck Seattle Circuit. I guess that'll be where I use my throwaway C-Class car. Yeah, if I plan this out right. So I've used a rally car, used an A-Class car. So I need to use an S-Class, a B-Class, a C-Class, and then probably another A-Class to finish us. Actually, to be fair, the last course is Test Course, so... What car will have the most speed on Test Course? Would I be better to just build something for Test Course, or like you just use something from a garage, or... Is there like an actual... Rhino, what did you use for Test Course? I know it was like a million years ago, but if you remember, please let me know, because I'm kind of curious. If you do know what you used for Arcade Mode Test Course... That's going to be a fun one. That's just going to be a case of just driving a car for full throttle for... about... well, at best 15 minutes, at worst... millions of hours, because Test Course in this game is really long! And really boring, and yeah, we're going to have to take it on in Toyota Yaris's at some point, because that sounds like my idea of fun. People wonder why I don't like GT3. People wonder, and then and they go, oh yeah, that's right, there's a race that literally requires you to drive Yaris's around Test Course for half an hour of your life, basically. Time to check the video. Oh no, time to go back and check videos. Also, ooh! Bad things. Many ooh. Alright, that was an interesting save. Not really sure how to feel about that. Like, on one hand, that was an awfully terrifying experience. On the other hand, that ended in about the best possible way an experience like that can end. Which I guess is something. Also, lap 4. Do the meme thing again, because bleh. Can't be arsed to take the corner properly at this point. Slow it down, speed it up, slow it down, no, speed it up. I don't even fucking know where these voices are coming from anymore. Well, they're all RCR ripoffs, but aren't we all on YouTube? Hey. Because we've all got to be ripping off someone, we can't just, you know, take inspiration. I don't even fucking know what I'm saying anymore. I would like to point out, oh, what? The Castrol NSX? I mean, it's not a terrible idea, I guess. How long did that take? Out of curiosity. Because I'd imagine long. I guess out of all the JGTC cars, though, that would probably be the one with the best straight line speed. I don't know. See, my other solution was maybe using the Corvette Z06, but I'm not really sure where the top end lies on the Z... Mind you, would the Z06 be quicker than the NSX in a straight line? I wonder what the NSX JGCC tops out at. Every Gran Turismo Forza LP is a rip-off of me. Hey, Lamal. Clearly. So, you and Rhino, how does it feel to be ripping off me? I did one stream of Forza Motorsport 6, I automatically own the rights to that entire game and every single video content production, whatever that comes out on that game. Gimme money. I require all of your ad revenue, which I'm assuming is about a dollar and a quarter. On professional, so about 10 minutes on hard. Oh, okay, that actually doesn't sound too bad, to be fair. If that's the case, why did you do it on professional? Oh yeah, I forgot, you're just fucking mental, aren't you? Also, yeah, the vlog was decent today. Too much Rosemary Kappa. No, I'm joking. I think she got like... She was in there twice, and one of them was watching that pretty brutal women's match, which I couldn't let you off for, because that was a fucking cool match. Also, not gonna lie, Decay's new theme song is actually quite good now that I've heard it a second time. Like, it's... I don't know if it's as good as the Marilyn Manson, but... no, the Corvettes... I'm not talking about the race car, I was talking about the road car. Just the A-class road car. I'm not sure what that could be paired with. Maybe the Viper, which would probably give it a run for its money. Either way, we are across the line. So that's good. Very good, in fact. So there we go. Evo 4 comes in last place. Poor Evo, except I was expecting that exact result. Anyways, we move on to the next race. The next race heads to Deep Forest Raceway, and for that we will go for a B-class car. And what B-class car will we go for? Kind of tempted to use the Blitzen. Because I like that car a lot. Ooh, Celica GT4, when did you pop up somewhere? You know what? I'm going to use the... Actually, I've already used that for... So... I'm going to use this car in the LP anyway, but I don't care, so whatever. We're using the Blitzen. Because Blitzen. It's a cool car, it's a Porsche tuned Legacy, what more do you want? Because that's best Legacy. People are going on about something in Discord. Don't really care. Right, four-wheel drive, power, FCR X7, why are you here? Why are all the cars here just Sylvias and other weeb cars? In fact, is there anything that isn't weeb here? Oh, there's a Clio V6 just sort of lurking there. Did you see Uncle Steve get his... Oh, crazy Uncle Steve? No, I did not see that. What happened? I think... I didn't know if he was on about it. Also, was his neck legitimately broken? I'm assuming not. Because he's not Nikki Bella, because she's more talented. Hey, I'm going to kill myself for that joke. Also, just destroyed the S15. Not gonna lie, the S15 is my favourite model of Sylvia, but that was kind of gratifying. Slightly. The only thing I don't like about the Blitzen is the weird rear wing. I think if I bought one, I wouldn't take it off or anything, but like, yeah, it's just a sort of weird design quirk. I'm assuming it holds some form of significance. He wasn't actually hurt. Unlike Adam Pacitti, who got hurled through a table by Bully Ray. Because, eh. Again, I don't know if it's unfortunate or not, but we can't. But it's still piled. He got pile driven through a table? Holy fucking shit. Oh yeah, TNA isn't WWE, it's not banned. Hey. Anyways. Mind you, it's not even TNA anymore, is it? I've got to say it correctly, it's Anthem Impact Wrestling. Ugh, wrestling! Did you see the thing about all the TNA talents? Oh, actually, shit, Rhino, did you see the thing I posted in my Bagel Club earlier about the whole Triple H plans and all that? Seffy poos is Seffy, ouch. I don't know. Seth ouchy. Seth rolling to the ER. Ha 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 ha. Kill me. But yeah, anyways, what the current plan on the table is to switch the AJ Styles Shane match to be the TNA's Total Hardcore, yeah. Yeah, the current plan is to switch the AJ Styles versus Shane McMahon match to Triple H versus Shane McMahon, which would be a hell of a lot better, because that means AJ Styles can actually do something, you know, not bollocks at SummerSlam, like actually face someone who deserves to face AJ Styles instead of a 44-year-old businessman. Granted, Shane can go in the ring, but Uncle Shane versus Daddy Trips, yeah. Like, granted, Shane can go in the ring, but, like, still, AJ should not be facing that man. AJ Styles versus Samoa Joe could be decent, but I'm not really sure how they'd build to that unless they would be, like... Unless they were like, oh hey, had Samoa Joe come on the mic and say like, oh, I came to Triple H's aid because I think SmackDown is cackdown, and yeah, I decided to come to Raw instead, and then you could have AJ Styles go, but bro, this is sort of my show, and then they can have a bit of a kerfuffle, and then at WrestleMania they can fight, and then I guess Styles can go over. Imagine Samoa Joe going over would probably be better at his first Mania. And then in the next brand draft, AJ will go to Raw and Samoa Joe will go to SmackDown, which is probably gonna happen because they're having another fucking draft. And AJ Styles is gonna go to Raw because Vince wants him. Because Vince has decided he likes Southern boys. Not that sort of Southern boy, but, you know. Ooh. Hi, Understeer. It's been fun knowing you. Also, apparently that Sylvia has managed to come back after being deafened. Or deft earlier. I don't know. Also... Roman Reigns heel turn coming, yay, kinda. Or at least... Apparently the whole reason they put him out there at number 30 was basically so Randy Orton would get as much reaction to winning in a good way as possible. So, yeah, I think the company sort of realised they might want to go ahead and make another Samoan heel. And that'd be cool. Guess. That would certainly be more interesting for Roman to be heel, because Roman looks like a heel, he talks like a heel, wrestles like a heel, he's a cunt like a heel. There's an S2000 silver and chrome looking bad like that. Fucking Dogs Trismo 3, still my favourite song from GT3, and everyone probably wants to kill me for that, considering I'm playing the PAL version that doesn't have that song in it, instead has a bunch of fruit feeder. But yeah, bro, Dogs Trismo 3, bro. Apparently, I can keep one single car can pass me in this race, and that's all that can happen. I've just realised the taillights on that Clio are not very well modelled. Although, again, this is a kind of very, very early... Mind you, I bet they're still exactly the same as that in fucking GT... What's it called? GT6, because, hey, Lamal, let's use 15-year-old models and just slightly improve them, except not, because the Polo on GT6 still has amazingly broken rear lights. Just like the GT4 Inception did. Sorry, I just need to itch my nose quickly. For some reason my nose always itches during these live streams. Cleo is covering my rear view mirror, which I guess if I got a Subaru Legacy would be about accurate, although it probably wouldn't be a Clio V6. It'd just be some normal 1.5 diesel Clio with Lexus lights, because why not? Trying to challenge a Subaru Legacy to a street race, because that makes perfect sense. Except it doesn't. There we go. Just don't cock up the last corner and we should be Solirio. Yep, we look like we're fine. Cleo's really too far behind to do anything about this. This race is mine. And there we go. Lovely. Pretty consistent lap times as well, to be fair, on that race. Also, the S13 came in last place. Why was the S13 racing in a B-class race? I will never know. Considering that car should probably be C-class, but there we go. Anyways, on to the next race. The next race heads to Special Stage Round 5, and for that, S-class vehicle, I guess? I guess I'll use an S-class vehicle. What should we use for this particular event? I've already used the Castrol Supra, didn't I? Fairly certain I did. Sod it, I'll use the Astra. Why not? I'll just go with something a bit weird and out there. So, sure, let's use the Vauxhall Astra. The V8 Astra, not like a SRI Astra. Like a properly quick Astra. So this should be pretty fun to see how this goes. And now after this... Oh god, I just saw XJ220, ah. It's fine, you never know, maybe the Astra... Wait, is that an XJ220? I didn't even know that the XJ220 race car was in this game. Strange. Oh well. And at the front, we just have all of the JGTC Civics ever. Oh, Civics? NSXs. They're not Civics. I do apologize. So what do? We have the Atria one, we have the Rayburg, and the Castrol one. So, hey, Lamel. Relax it. Oh. Was I getting pushed wide? It felt like I was getting pushed wide there. Doesn't matter, I'll still make up time. It honestly felt like I was being pushed there though, I'm not gonna lie. Because I was sort of trying to take it careful through there. I got the rear end going a little bit, but there is no way I would have got that much oversteer. Problem is, I've got no vibration, so I can't really tell. Whether I'm being pushed sideways or not. Anyways, we shall rebuild. Apparently I'm already catching the other guys at godspeed. Yeah, I was 7 seconds behind, now I'm 4.9. I'm assuming after coming through here, excuse me, I will be a hell of a lot closer than that. Now we go through there, on the brakes, try and get around the Jag. The big old bruiser Jag. Alright, so he's out the way. Cool. Moving on to the Falcon. Let's hope I don't get pushed wide at the next corner. Falcon is quite quick through here, not gonna lie. Or the Falcon is... I think he's quicker straight line than anything else. Yeah, see, that time I wasn't getting pushed sideways and it felt absolutely fine. Alright, here we go. I like how all these... Mind you, to be fair, I'd expect nothing less than all these NSXs to sort of stick together because they are sort of the same car. In fact, they are exactly the same car, if we're being perfectly honest. Either way. I like it how they, for some reason, made this the Vauxhall Astra V8 race car in this version of the game, considering I don't think, like, the Astra, the Vauxhall version of this car never existed. I mean, to be fair, it didn't have the Calibra either. So it's still got, like, all of the German advertising on it, but it's just got Vauxhall on it for some reason. I literally do not understand why. But there we go. That is the way this world turns sometimes. Turns in weird and strange ways. And for some reason it all involves Vauxhall Astras. Alright. Good handling car this though. I believe this is I'm fairly certain this is a DTM car. Ooh. A little bit of sliding there. Just decided to go into third person mode just so I can sort of see, hey, I'm driving a Vauxhall Astra, which is weird. I believe compared to the one in Forza, this one is a 2000, well, this is just a 2000s model, and the one in Forza is a 2004, I want to say. So the one in Forza 4 has much different rear lights. Meanwhile, it's an Opel in the North American version. Yep. Oh, it's not an Opel. Strange. Because I'm fairly certain the Vauxhall version of this car doesn't exist. I think I did try to search it up once, and no, the Vauxhall version of this car doesn't exist. There is a Vauxhall Astra touring car, but it's not a DTM car. Because it's BTCC. Admittedly, it is also an Astra Coupe, which I guess is sort of kind of more like this vehicle, but still, granted. Well, sorry, as every Astra owner will chew my ass if I don't say it. It's the Vauxhall Astra Bertone Coupe, because it's styled by Bertone. And it might even be built by them, but it still doesn't make it not a Vauxhall Astra. It is a kind of good-looking car, though, I'll give them that. Although the Peugeot 406 Pininfarina is much prettier. But that car doesn't make the fucking jump into next-gen until GT4, because, yeah. You can't have nice things, you'll never have nice things. Yeah. I think some guy was on about it. Yeah, this was most likely... Yeah. And I guess they just did the Vauxhall version for some reason? I mean, it doesn't... Here's the thing, it doesn't bother me on a cultural thing whether it's a Vauxhall or an Opel. You know, I'd rather it be an Opel because it means it's not going to fall to bits. Or at least as quickly. You know, I just find it kind of strange. It's like Forza uses Vauxhall as well instead of going with Opel. Like, they're using the... well, they're adding the Vauxhall Corsa VXR to Horizon 3 over the Opel Corsa, I guess it's the Opel Corsa OPC over there? It's just, it's a strange dynamic. They seem to think we'll be offended if it's not a Vauxhall. It's like, we really don't care. Unless they just sort of looked at the Lotus Carlton and said, well, that's a Vauxhall, everything else should be a pissing Vauxhall. I have no idea. I mean, Opels do exist in Horizon games. You know, you got the GT and the Cadet. I think there's another one actually as well. But oh yeah, the Manta as well. But for whatever reason, Vauxhall just exists over Opel for reasons I don't quite understand. So there we go. Anyways, just gonna compose myself and go for the victory. And there we go, that was actually our quickest lap. No, it wasn't. What am I talking about? It was much quicker than the last lap, though. Hey, the V8 supercar finished second, and the XJ220 finished in last, because that makes perfect sense. Anyways, I will take that first place prize, and we move on to the next race. The next race heads to Seattle Circuit, and we're going to be using the C-Class car for this event. What C-Class car are we going to be using though? That is the question. Don't want to go for anything down there. Did I use the Altezza before? Got a funny feeling I did. So So, sod it, I'm going to use the SLK. I've already used it in the Let's Play, and I'll probably use it again in the Let's Play, but whatever, it's the most OP car in C-Class. Or rather, it's the most, well, by far and away, the most usable car in C-Class, so... Either way. Let's see what happens. We've got a PT Cruiser in this race, by God. What else have we got in this race? A PT Cruiser, a Storia, an MR2, a Celica. Juno, it's like a standard front wheel drive Celica, nice. Yeah, you see what I mean about the SLK being sort of the OP car of C-Class? Yeah, it sort of is, apparently. I have no idea why this thing is, mind you, I guess, mind you, B-Class, no, this thing wouldn't be outclassed in B-Class, really. I mean, neither would the Altezza, realistically. But hey, whatever. I was trying to use the Storia on this track, but ultimately I just... Unlike with the Mini, where I sort of tried and tried and tried to the point where I was like, hey, listen, you know, this is, you could do it in the Mini, but to stop you pestering me about the Mini, I'm just gonna do it with the car and say, oh, it was a bit of a failure, and then just sort of do it in a different car. With this, it's very much a case of I don't like Seattle. I don't like Seattle, and I haven't really got the patience right now to sort of deal with trying to do a, you know, romantic hero story. So I was like, fuck it, we'll just use the OP car, which turns out to be the SLK. I can't even remember the SLK I used in the Let's Play was yellow. I think I used a green one. Don't quote me on that. I don't know, maybe I did use a yellow one, I've just used the same colour car twice. Either way, as I was saying with the Supra earlier, it's a case of what haven't I used in the Let's Play, what don't I want to use in the Let's Play, and what people wouldn't expect. When it comes to sort of the arcade mode and it's a limited car roster, I can do that to a certain extent, and also the fact that there's certain cars which are just way, way, way more powerful than the other cars in their class, such as this. You know, the best opening lap I could get was Storia, where I got everything correct, was a 2.11, and I've just set a 2.05.7. The best lap I could get in the Storia overall was a 2.03.999. So, kind of curious to see what can be done here. Assuming not a lot. Either way, apparently I'll get screaming at me about low bandwidth. What I might actually do is just shut the stream off and record the rest of this as is. Yeah, I'm gonna do that, just give me 1 second. May as well just turn it off, because no one's watching anyway right now, because it's quite late at night. It's about 11:30 here, so sod it, we'll just turn the stream off. Hopefully that hasn't affected the recording. I don't think it has. Let me just go ahead and... Yeah, looks fine on that end. Let's just pull. May as well pull this across now. There we go. I've only been recording 55 minutes. Okay, fair enough. But yeah, may as well record the rest of this solo. Nothing happening in the chat, anyways. So yeah. Again, I can't blame anyone because it's like 11:30, and most of the Americans have sort of woken up and are now going to get dinner and stuff, so... Yeah. And if it's gonna scream low bandwidth at me, then... whatever, may as well shut it down instead of trying to... adapt... to it, I guess, so... I was streaming for, like, over... 2 and a bit hours, so... You know, it's not like I was lowballing people on the streaming thing or anything. Excuse me. Anyways, thanks to my experience with Need for Speed Underground, hopefully I am a little bit more confident in doing these sort of solo let's play bits now. But yeah, I mean, this track's perfectly doable in the story, admittedly. It's more than perfectly doable. It is perfectly viable to go ahead and do it in the story, but ultimately for me, you know, it's just like, you know, I can essentially get... I can... essentially, like here, you can see, like I said, best time of the Storia, 203.999, in this car, 2 minutes, 0.6. I've crashed into several walls. I'm not even really paying attention to the way I'm driving this thing right now, and it's just, it's madness. Again, as I've said before, you know, realistically, us as Let's Players, we're only really adding challenge to these races. If you was to do arcade mode at home, you know, use the you'd basically, what you'd be doing is, even if you're switching classes up to sort of save yourself going mad, you'd still be using only the SLK, the S2K, and the... what's it in A-Class? There's an OP one in A-Class. Guess, like, the NSX is pretty good. Oh, the R34 is also quite good. One of those two, and then S-Class, of course, it's basically just use the JGCC cars. Other than that, if you want to use anything else, buying a Scudo in the career mode, which, you know, that's just the best way to do those races, realistically. Anyways, as you can see, under 2 minute lap time there, which isn't actually that terrible for Seattle, admittedly. Still. The brakes. Lovely. Big Acura sign, big Mopar. Mopar. Firestone. Firestone tires. Just a bunch of random advertisements along the streets here in Seattle. I think that's like a parking lot or something. I don't know. It's kind of interesting to see the amount of detail that did go into creating the Seattle circuit, because there's a fair amount of it here. You know, it's one of these tracks where you go, wow, look at the detail. It's sort of like Horizon 3 in that regard. Well, actually, every single Forza game. It's one of those places where it's like, wow, look at the detail they went to, until you, like, start looking at the stuff really, really, really close and realise they probably made about, I don't know, 5 unique asset buildings, and they probably just kept reusing them. Admittedly, I haven't seen the same building twice, really, but still. Also, the mighty under-construction stadium over there. Which is, of course, the actual stadium in Seattle now. That is sort of the main stadium now. I do find it kind of cool how that stadium there, you know, by the time both this, well, I think in this game it was fairly sort of like that was starting to be demolished as they start moving into that stadium there. Well, they were like a couple of weeks away from moving into that stadium. And then in GT4, it's like, yeah, they've, like, way already moved into that stadium to the point where that one's been knocked down. I just find that pretty amusing. The fact that, you know, they kept reusing the same model, and fair play to them, you know. For me, it's sort of a case of, when it comes to game design, don't, you know, if you can keep reusing the same asset, great, just don't make it obvious. You know, like, with this track, you know, of course the stadium, just give it away. I find it kind of amusing more than anything. But, you know, I'm talking in terms of, you know, Forza, I believe they reuse, like, little bits of cars. Like, they reuse, like, taillight designs, like, the Mark III Supra. I think they said they, like, reused a few of the accessories on there. You know, they even came out and freely admitted it. But normally when you look at that car, you can't really tell unless you're, like, looking for it. Well, there's, like, stuff like the car model reuse in Gran Turismo, and I don't want to crap on the Gran Turismo games while I'm playing a Gran Turismo game because I think they're fantastic, but like just with like GT5 and GT6, where you can like so tell the difference between the standard and premium cars, it's almost insane. In fact, it is pretty much insane. You know, like, again, just reuse assets as long as you can still make them look good, and as long as the people can't tell unless they look for it. You know, that's sort of always been one of my fears to game design. I don't know. I'm not a game designer. I have a qualification in game design, but I'm not a game designer. I designed a game once. It was like a top-down thing. It's like Micro Machines, essentially. It's a pretty fun game, actually. You'll never, ever, ever, ever get to play it or see it or anything, but because it was a college project, which I've since destroyed, but yeah. Nevertheless, we're going to win this race in the OP car. I do apologise for using the obvious choice, but sometimes the obvious choice, is the best choice. Also, look, the Sirion finishes behind a PT Cruiser. That showed you how successful the Sirion was going to be. Although, to be fair, I have to hand it to it, I'm on a bad car. Anyways, let's head on to our final race of today. The final race of today, it heads to the test course. Yep. Yes, indeed, Ian. Of course, we're not using C-class cars for that. We're probably going to use an S-class car. And we're going to go for... we'll go for one of the NSXs. I guess we'll use the Atria just to be different. But yeah, you may have noticed during the bit with the Supra earlier, the Rhino GT4 was in the chat. He said he used the NSX for himself personally. So we'll give his NSX strategy a go, because I can't be bothered to figure out if there's a better way to do it or not. He's usually pretty on the money with these games though, so yeah, we'll see how well this goes. Admittedly, he used the Castrol NSX, and this is the Atria Aerobax one, but I don't think it'd make that much of a difference, if I'm being honest. Because apparently the poor little Astra just is... Oh god, there's a list of storm in this race. Also, hi Slipstream Speeds. How are you doing? Yeah, okay. This might be the best strategy of them all, apparently. Slipstream Speed was quite quick in this car. Other than that, I don't think... Yeah, I'm not really going to have much to talk about during this oval race, to say the least, but yeah, I guess they can't, well, maybe they will throw test course in reverse at me. There is a big possibility they might do that, to be fair, because this is, of course, Gran Turismo. Ooh. Let's start using Slipstream Speed again. Slipstream Speed was the best speed. Where's the point where the revs get unhappy in this car? I don't know, but apparently him slipstreaming behind the list, the best he can do is 315 kilometers. So I'm assuming the Lister is technically the fastest car of this bunch. There we go, 315. Seems to be about right. This is just going to be essentially a case of piggybacking the entire way, I'd imagine. Which is fair enough for me, of course. But it means this race can be over quicker, because I can just piggyback off of everyone else's aerodynamic abilities. And we can still win the first lap. So that's something. Anyways, let's help this guy out a bit, I guess. Either get him to push us or get him to slipstream past us. There you go, buddy. You go past. Now just use your rear end as a nice little bit of a boost. Yeah, admittedly, test course in GT2 was a hell of a lot better for racing around normally, just because when you raced around test course in GT2 normally, it was a hell of a lot shorter. than this particular incarnation, which is a lot, and I mean a lot longer than the previous one. In fact, I believe the one in GT2 was like 6 miles all round. This one is about 10 miles in circumference, which is pretty darn expansive, admittedly. I think the Lister car might be quicker in terms of actual straight line speed, but the NSXs are a little bit quicker in terms of actual when they're in slipstream, maybe. I don't know, something like that. Doesn't really matter, because at least it's keeping this race interesting for us, in the sense that, yeah, cars are just sort of moving around and slipstreams and stuff. Either way, we're going to sit behind the Lister Storm. 311 on the speedo and get past him. Yeah, I guess it makes racing a test course interesting. I think I might use that line before in this, I'm not sure. Yeah, I guess it makes it interesting if nothing else. Sorry, I've got a bit of an itch going on. There we go. Oh no, it's the Ray Burger NSX. Or Ray Brig. I always call it the Ray Burg. You know, it's really Ray Brig. It doesn't really matter, does it? It's still a cool looking design for a JGCC car, though, is this. The Ray Bring. Or Ray Brig, as I should be calling it now. Yeah, that's another cool design for a race car, the Lister Storm. Just a shame it's, well, it's never really been in anything other than Gran Turismo, and I believe it was in some other sim racing game, which I don't care about. But, yeah, it's a shame that car never really got in much else. I think it was in Need for Speed games before, I'm not sure though, I haven't played. Underground's about like the oldest Need for Speed game that I've actually played with any form of frequency or care. So, I mean, I've played High Stakes, but yeah, I don't really care for High Stakes. It's just sort of something I got forced into playing more than anything else. In fact, it was more to shut people up who were like, "Oh, High Stakes is the best Need for Speed game." I was like, "Is it? Let me check." And I was like, "Oh no, it's not." It's a good game, it's just a painfully average racing game in my honest opinion. Even counting the era it was in. It was probably a good game. Actually, to be fair, it's a good game for its era, but modern days Gran Turismo 2 is a much more fun and engaging experience. Anyways. So yeah, this is basically going to be a case of piggybacking until the end of the race. Quite literally. Just got to make sure I can stay in front during the sort of ending, dying moments of the race. Otherwise, that's going to be a frustrating affair, shall we say. I think frustrating affair sums it up pretty darn well. Go on, get past the Lister. There we go. Lap 4 of 5. We're not too far from done, thank God. But yeah, I don't think there's a reverse test course in this game, so I guess one saving grace is this is going to be it for test course. The one bad thing is, honestly, I would much rather race test course than, say, Grand Valley Speedway in reverse, which I'm assuming is going to be one of the tracks. I don't even know what the next, like, pick of tracks is going to be. Like, the only tracks I can think that like, we haven't really raced around is Special Stage Route 11, Tahiti Maze. And that's, like, it. Unless Complex String's in here. It could very well be. I don't remember ever racing any cars at Complex String, but maybe it is. Actual track we have to race here, which I'd be fine with because I actually do like Complex String, so Yeah, most people don't. I do, though, because I'm a bit strange like that. I've always kind of liked... I've not always kind of, just in more recent times, I kind of liked the complex string track. For some reason, I'm not really sure why, if I'm being honest. Either way... Bye-bye, Lister. That's not really what I wanted to do. Alright, final lap. Just gotta make sure I'm in slipstream. Just gotta make sure the list is essentially ahead of me before that, that final corner so I can slipstream off him in the corner. Ooh. I've just found the, limit of my car's rev range, which is 316 kilometers an hour. Which isn't all that fast. Well, I mean, 300 kilometers an hour is 180 miles an hour. So, if you wanted a rough thing, so. It's about 190-ish, I would say. Yeah, 190-ish sounds about logical from there. I mean, I guess as far as sticking in the slipstream until the corner goes, this is something I could do. Just sort of push him along like that. Actually, that might not be a terrible idea either. Just gotta pick my own moment around this bit here. And that was not really my moment. Shit. Oh, bollocks. Cocking bollocks. Cocking bollocks, 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 cunt, bollocks. Oh. Thank you, Rayburg. Have you saved this for me? You very well just have, you magnificent, magnificent machine. Rayburg JTCC car, the best a man can get. Well, I guess it was a tense race at least. Apparently the other Atar Civic did not... I'm assuming the other NSX has just sort of ran away from him a bit, and the Astra is just nowhere to be seen, unfortunately. Anyways, that is that. And let's exit out of here because that was our final race of Group C. Which is good. Didn't take nearly as long as Group B did. At least in terms of recording times, because I did, what, 1 hour and 40 for the last one. This is 1 hour 15 currently. So yeah, there you go, that's C-Class done. Anyways, next time out we'll be tackling D-Class, which to be fair doesn't even look all that challenging. And for the cars that we got, Rhino already came in earlier to say that the cars we are going to be unlocking are going to be A-Class and S-Class respectively. So let's take a look at the A-Class car we got, which is going to be the Mazda RX-8 concept car, which actually comes in a couple of different colours. A really cool car, actually. I do love the Mazda RX-8 concept car, so that's good. And the S-Class car we're going to be getting is the Gillett Vertigo, which is a very interesting car. Apparently this one's powered by an Alfa Romeo V6, I'd imagine. So yeah, two pretty interesting cars from there. So that's cool. Anyways, friends, that is going to be it for this episode of the Gran Turismo 3 A-Spec Let's Play. I do hope you've enjoyed. Next time, we're going to be taking a look at the D block of events, so join me for that. Anyways, I want to thank you all very much for watching. Mine's been the Real Emil. Until next time, farewell.